Thank you. John, you have brought your beautiful daughter to be married. It's a special relationship between the father and his daughter, and it's lovely that you are here by her side, demonstrating your love and support. Would you like to give your daughter a kiss? And your future son-in-law, shake of the hand. Please be seated, everyone. Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the Regency Room for our ceremony today. I'd like to extend a particularly warm welcome to Jamie and Beth on this very special and happy day, your wedding day. Jamie and Beth have found in each other happiness, fulfilment and love. Through your vows here today, you'll be making a pledge of lifelong commitment to each other, and in so doing, you'll strengthen and deepen the relationship that already clearly exists between you. On exchanging those vows, you will leave here united as husband and wife. A wedding is a celebration, a time to be shared with the people you love. And so being here today, you are all demonstrating your love and support for Jamie and Beth. And so on their behalf, thank you very much. My name is Meriel, and it's a pleasure and privilege to be leading you through the ceremony today. I'd also like to introduce to you my very esteemed friend and colleague who has a very important job of legally registering your marriage. I have to begin formally by explaining that this place in which we're all met has been duly sanctioned according to law for the celebration of marriages, and that we are gathered here today to witness the joining in marriage of Jamie Matthew Clark and Bethany Rachel Little. However, before we proceed, if any person here present knows of any lawful reason why these two may not be joined in matrimony, you should declare it now. Very nervous silence, but we are ready to go. So we are going to begin the ceremony with a reading by Kirsten. So Kirsten might step forward.
This is a poem by William G. Smith. Now touch the air softly, step gently, one, two. I love you till roses are robin's egg blue. I love you till gravel is eaten for bread, and lemons are orange and lavender's red. Now touch the air softly, swing gently the broom. I love you till windows are all of a room, and the table is laid, and the table is bare, and the ceiling reposes in bottomless air. I love you till heaven rips stars from his coat, and the moon rows away in a glass-bottomed boat, and Orion steps down like a river below, and the earth is ablaze and the oceans aglow. So touch the air softly and swing the broom high. We'll dust the grey mountains and sweep the blue sky. And I love you as long as the furrow of the plough, and however is ever and ever is now.
And so we have come together to join the two of you in matrimony, but I must remind you of the important commitment that you are about to make. Marriage in this country means the union of two people voluntarily entered into for life, to the exclusion of all others. It is solemn and it is binding. But more than this, it is intended to provide the love, support, comfort and friendship each will share with the other as you go through your lives together. Civil ceremony is very brief, just the exchange of two sets of declarations, each repeated after me. The first is when you declare that you are free to marry, and the second is that lovely moment when you take each other as partners in your marriage. Having already met you both, quite sure the answer is yes, but I do have to ask you one last time, are you ready to make those declarations? Will you both please stand? Beth, you might put your okay on the table. So, I'm going to start with you, Jeremy, and if you repeat after me. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Jamie Clark.
Why I, Jamie Clark.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Bethany Whittle.
To Bethany Whittle.
I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Bethany Whittle.
Why I, Bethany Whittle.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Jamie Clark.
To Jamie Clark.
So I'm now going to make a short statement to each of you in turn, which I invite the response, I do. Very simple, yes, it's so fine. So Jamie, we'll start with you again. Jamie, do you take Beth to be your lifelong partner? Do you promise to cherish her? To be loving, faithful, loyal and kind to her for all the days of your life?
I do.
Beth, do you take Jamie to be your lifelong partner? Do you promise to cherish and respect him? To be loving, faithful, loyal and kind to him for all the days of your life?
I do.
James and Oliver, please stand up. So you are going to sign the schedule after the ceremony to say that you have witnessed and understood what's taking place here today. If you'd like to face each other and hold hands. I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon these persons here present.
To witness that I, Jamie.
To witness that I, Jamie.
Do take thee, Beth.
Do take thee, Beth.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon these persons here present.
To witness that I, Beth.
To witness that I, Beth.
Do you take thee, Jamie?
Do you take thee, Jamie?
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
Can you sit down now, please? So the ancient and traditional way. Keep standing. The ancient and traditional way of sealing the marriage vow is by the giving and receiving of rings. The wedding ring is an unbroken circle. Represents the unending and everlasting love that each will share with you, that you both will share with each other as you go through your marriage. So, Chris, if you'd like to give Jamie Beth's ring. Taking his job very seriously.
We did put two.
And if you could place the ring on the end of Beth's finger and say these words after me. Beth, I give you this ring.
Beth, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of our marriage.
As a symbol of our marriage.
And a token of my love.
And a token of my love.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I have, I share with you.
All that I have, I share with you.
All of my love, I promise you.
All of my love, I promise you.
Jamie, I give you this ring.
Jamie, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of our marriage.
As a symbol of our marriage.
And a token of my love.
And a token of my love.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I have, I share with you.
All that I have, I share with you.
All of my love, I promise you.
All of my love, I promise you.
Now, Jamie and Beth have got some personal words that they would like to share with each other and with you. So, maybe Beth, you'd like to come first.
Yeah. I shut my eyes and all the world drops dead. I lift my lids and all is born again. I think I made you inside my head.
I could put a tennis racket up against my face and pretend that I'm Kendall and Mesa.
When you're signing the schedule, now we have, if you'd like to take a seat now, and Peter has got our second reading.
I carry your heart with me, I carry it in. By E.E. Cummings. I carry your heart with me. I carry it in my heart. I am never without it. Anywhere I go, you go, my dear. And whatever is done by only me is your doing, my darling. I fear no fate, for you are my fate, my sweet. I want no world, for beautiful you are my world, my true, and it's you, are whatever a moon has always meant. And whatever a sun will always sing is you. Here is the deepest secret nobody knows. Here is the root of the root and the bud of the bud and the sky of a tree called life, which grows higher than soul can hope or mind can hide. And this is the wonder that's keeping the stars apart. I carry your heart, I carry it in my heart.
So, Jamie and Beth, you have made here today the declarations required by law. Before your family and friends, who are gathered here in your honour and in front of City's Registrar of Marriages, you have made a solemn binding contract with one another. You have sealed that contract with the giving and receiving of rings, and you've made promises to each other of love, loyalty, and commitment. The poet Edmund O'Neill has said, when two people pledge their love and care for each other in marriage, they create a spirit unique unto themselves, which binds them closer than any spoken or written word. Marriage is a promise. A potential made in the hearts of two people that it takes a lifetime to fulfil. I'm very pleased to say that that lifetime starts right now as I declare that you are now lawfully married. Congratulations.
Thank you.
sure you had a fantastic day there. We would like, on behalf of myself and Dendy and everyone at Bright Register Office, to wish you a lovely day and a very long and happy marriage together. Dendy has something to give you. Let's just get us right here for a moment.
Pleasure to present this to you, which comes with our very, very best wishes for a fantastic day today and many more to come. Thank you.
Would everyone join me one last time in congratulating the happy couple, Beth and Jamie?
Thank you.